Good morning, everyone. I'm not even sure what the date is.
October 6th.
Yes, it's October 6th, and this is St. Francis weekend. And we had some St. Francis yesterday morning from Ama Ruth, and you're going to have a little bit more today from me. And let's open in prayer, and let's just let the spirit of St. Francis be with us and around us and fill us as we enter into this service. Oh, great and glorious God, Master Jesus and Mother Mary, we are so thankful for this day and for all the days in the calendar where we can reflect on those who have gone before us, who have given us gifts and blessings, who have made a groove in the earth that we might be better servants of yours. Thank you this day for just loving us and for the things that St. Francis did and the things that have come down through the ages. All those many, many years ago that were set in motion by his love for you. Calm our hearts and our minds. Let our problems melt away now as we spend time in communion with each other and with you. We ask these things in your name, in the name of the Creator, the Mediators, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Time for some music.
Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, where there is doubt, where there is despair, where there is doubt. Understood.
Thank you for that beautiful, beautiful music. It certainly goes along with the title of the sermon, Blessed by St. Francis. I don't think that there's anything that I hear, and I hear it often, that touches me so deeply as the St. Francis prayer, and of how he lived his life and what he left for us to learn from. So I want to tell you that today I am really excited to be here, because I shouldn't be here, because I already was here twice in the last month, so it should be somebody else's turn. But when Mama Ruth said the call out and said, oh, we need somebody to do Sunday service, I said, oh, St. Francis, I could do that. And then I was like, no, behave. You've already done it twice. Just be quiet. And then she called me. She called me on Saturday and said, would you like to do the service? I was like, yeah, I'd like to do the service. So I am just so thankful that I could do this, and that you are all here, and that we as a group are supporting this process of learning and unfolding. And I think when each of us who do sermons, when we're doing them, there's a different method that each of us have. Like nobody, some people like just do it, like just do it. And I would be like stumbling all over the place, even more so than not knowing what the date is. So I was driving here to Maine yesterday, and it's a 6.5 hour drive. And I had the radio off, and I was still and quiet and driving, but alert, and waiting to hear what was I going to talk about today. 6.5 hours. Not a single hint of what today was going to look like. So I arrived in Harmony, Maine around maybe 5:30, and I brought all the animals in and fed everybody and got the wood stove going. And I was like, hint? Just a hint. You don't have to unfold the whole thing. I just need to have some idea where I'm going with this. And I didn't feel panicky or deserted. I just felt like, okay, it's going to come eventually. And then I had a bowl of popcorn without salt and butter. The butter was still in the car. That was my dinner. And I thought, well, you know, I'll look and see about the books. One of the problems that some of you might not know, that my house in Harmony, I had the Wi-Fi shut off, because I'm only there a few times in the summer. And it seemed crazy to pay all that money for a whole year when I wasn't going to use it. Well, maybe it wasn't so crazy, because I really miss it when I go and there's no Wi-Fi. So I had no Wi-Fi, and all the books, which are a number in the thousands, that I would use for references about St. Francis. Most of my books are in Putney, Vermont. And so I thought, well, okay, I'll go and I'll look at the scant, and I mean scant, like one shelf of books that didn't get packed, that's in my old media room. And I go in, and the first book on top is it's a historical fiction of St. Francis's life. It's so good, but I couldn't use that for a sermon, because you'd be here till like 2 in the afternoon. I'd want to read you the whole book. And so I thought, well, that's nice, but that's not going to help me. And then I went through the books, and then there was this book, Praying with St. Francis. I said, God, what is the chances that of all the books that I leave behind, I leave this one behind, and that I'm asked to do a service, and now I have everything I need. I don't even have to like do anything. I don't have to look up Bible verses, or I don't have to look up anything. It all came to me in one little parcel. And I was feeling incredibly blessed. I mean, just unbelievably blessed. And so I went to bed early, and I was thinking about St. Francis the whole time. And then I realized, most of us have like the St. Francis gene. So there I was laying in bed. I had a cat sitting on my head. I had a dog next to me, really cuddled up close. I had about an 18-pound cat that had walked up my body and plopped himself on my chest. And he doesn't have any reason to like me because he just had 11 teeth taken out and 2 weeks of antibiotics. You know, he sees me with the syringe and he wants to run, but I'm stronger than him. And so he has no reason to even like me. And here he is sitting right smack dab on my chest. And then baby kitty is curled up around my left arm. And I was just smiling that St. Francis gives us so much to relate to. And one of my favorite pictures, I used to teach saints classes every week. And one of my favorite ones is St. Francis and Claire. And Claire just also is just sweet and amazing servant of God. And so I was thinking about all the things that I know about St. Francis. And I don't know how many of you really know a lot about his background. So I'd like to give you like a 2-minute biography of him that would show where he came from, so how he could do things. The stuff in this book, Praying with St. Francis, is actually a translation of his own writings. So it's when I was in awe as I was reading it, like, whoa, look at this. This is what St. Francis wrote as close as we could, as the translation would be from the old Italian. So St. Francis was born into a very wealthy family. His father was a fabric merchant, and they were very, very wealthy, and they were considered noblemen. And he had a really good education, thus he could write. And he went off to the Crusades. And he was kind of a wild child before he went off to the Crusades. And he had everything he wanted in life. He had lots of money. He had women. He had anything that he wanted, he could go for. And he came back from the Crusades broken. I don't remember what happened in the Crusades, but I'm sure it was gruesome. And he came back a changed person. And when he came back, he fell ill. And he was delusional. And he was really sick for quite a long time. And during this time that he was sick, God spoke to him. And he knew that he had to give his life to God. And so he started doing really wild things. If any of you saw, Father, Son, Sister Moon. I don't even know if that's the title of it, but he does all these crazy things. So he takes his father's fabric, which is for the noble people and beautiful and fine and expensive, and throws it out the window to the common people. And, his father has a fit, and so he goes to the father uses the church to try to get St. Francis back into line. And so they had a meeting in the church, and St. Francis took off all of his clothes and gave them back to his father and then walked out of the church. He just started doing a lot of radical things. And my favorite picture of him is in the forest talking to the animals of, there's less squirrels and chipmunks and raccoons and somebody's interpretation of him relating to the animals. And so I did a lot of reading 25 years ago about St. Francis, and he was an amazing leader. You know, he founded an order. And he was just an amazing leader. And he was so kind to his followers. And it wasn't like, these are the rules. If you don't follow the rules, then you're in trouble. But he had one person who had a girlfriend back home, and he just longed to be back home. And St. Francis said, go, you know. Obviously, your ministry's not here. go back home and serve God. And I felt like, wow, that's kind of the essence of who he was as he served. And you know, they begged, they would go out with their bowls and they would get food and they would help the poor. And they were the poor and they helped the poor. And it was a pretty exciting time of study when I was doing St. Francis, and to see how this man lived. And he did have the stigmata, and they lived in really rough. Well, you have to remember it was 1200, like maybe between 1200 and 1240. So things weren't very luxurious then, even if you had had things. So I wanted us today to think about the gifts that the blessings that St. Francis has given us. And one of the things that I wanted to plant a seed for is like today, all around the world is the blessing of the animals. And I follow an Episcopal church in Massachusetts. I just think they really do an amazing work. And it's nice to see when a religious institution is doing something for God and it's really in the spirit. And so today they're having the blessing of the animals. They're doing it outside. My thing is, oh, they should bring them into the church, but they probably have had some experiences in the past. So this year they're blessing the animals outside. But I thought, like, we could do that next year. We could do a blessing of the animals. There could be one in Connecticut. There could be one in Seattle. There could be one in Vermont. You know, we could have blessing of the animals and we could all record them so that the people could see them, you know, all the different ones. And I was like, oh, yes, yes. One of the many gifts that we have received is being able to do this. And I was reflecting on, I worked with Dr. Hawkins, David Hawkins, for a really short time before he transitioned. And he would talk all the time about the animals. And he had a run-in with a poisonous snake once. And he just like talked to the snake and got the snake to like let him pass. And he was always talking about beetles. He said, you know, if you see a beetle on the sidewalk and it's on its back, flip it over. And then one day I read the thing, teach your children to turn over bugs because both the bug and the child will benefit. You know, there is something about being compassionate to all living creatures. And I actually think that goes into even plants. Like when I kill a plant, I'm crushed. I'm crushed that I took the life of a plant. So I think it's good to have this conscious awareness, and that it's not just for human beings, because boy, they're the ones that you can see it just by spending 10 minutes out in public. You can see how much they need to be loved, how much they need to be turned over and set right so that they can walk and know God and be in a place that's different from the pain that they suffer on a daily basis. So I wanted to read you these things, and a couple of them are pretty long. And so just clear your mind and just hear what St. Francis wrote for you, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, 20, like 800 or 900 years ago. The Canticle of the Sun. Most high, all-powerful, good Lord, yours are the praises and glory, the honor and all blessings. To you alone, most high, do they belong, and no man is worthy to mention your name. Praise be to you, my Lord, with all your creatures, especially Sir Brother Sun, who is the day and through whom you we get light. And he is beautiful and radiant with great splendor and bears a likeness to you, Most High One. Praise be to you, my Lord, through Sister Moon and the stars. In heaven, you form them clear and precious and beautiful. Praise be to you, my Lord, through Brother Wind and through the air, cloudy and serene, and every kind of weather, through which you give sustenance to your creatures. Praise to you, my Lord, through Sister Water, which is very useful and humble and precious and chaste. Praise to you, my Lord, through Brother Fire, whose light was through whom you light the night, and he is beautiful and playful and robust and strong. Praise to you, my Lord, through our sister Mother Earth, who sustains and governs us, who produces various fruits and colored flowers and herbs. Praise to you, my Lord, through those who give pardon for your love and bear infirmities and tribulations. Blessed are those who endure in peace, for by you, Most High, they shall be crowned. Praise to you, my Lord, through our Savior and through the sister bodily death, from whom no living man can escape. Woe to those who die in sin. Blessed are those whose death will find us in the most holy will, for the second death will have them no harm. Praise and blessed are we, my Lord. We give you thanks, and we serve you with great humility. You are holy, Lord, the only God. You do wonders. You are strong. You are great. You are the Most High. You are the mighty King, holy, holy Father, the King of heaven and earth. You are three in one. Lord God of gods, you are good, all good, the highest good. Lord God, living true. You are love and charity. You are wisdom, you are humility, you are patience, you are beauty, you are meekness, you are security, you are inner peace, you are joy, you are our hope and joy, you are justice, you are moderation, you are all our riches, you are enough for us. You are beauty, you are meekness, you are the protector. You are our guardian and defender. You are our strength. You are our refreshment. You are our hope. You are our faith. You are our charity. You are all sweetness. You are eternal life. Great and wonderful Lord, God mighty, merciful Savior. One of the things when you read a lot about St. Francis is he's always blessing. Now, there's always that blessing. And he did a thing on blessed are. So these are the blessed are's. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. The servants of God cannot know how much patience and humility he has within him, as long as everything goes well with him. But when the time comes in which those who should do him justice do quite the opposite to him, he has only as much patience and humility as he has on the occasion, and no more. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs. They are many who, applying themselves instantly to prayer and good deeds, engage in the good, and leave the scandalous, These persons are not poor in spirit, but a person who is truly poor in spirit hates himself and loves those who strike him on the cheek. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. The true peacemakers are those who preserve peace of mind and body for love of our Lord Jesus Christ, despite what they suffer in the world. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. The true pure of heart are those who despise the earth. No. Are those who despise the things of earth and seek the things of heaven, and who never cease to adore and behold the Lord, God living, true in the pure heart and soul. Blessed is the servant who does not pride himself on the good that the Lord says or does through him, any more than what he says or does through another. Blessed is the person who bears with his neighbor in the weakness to the degree that he would wish to be sustained by him if he were in a similar situation. Blessed is the servant who attributes every good to our Lord God, for he will hold back. For he who holds back something for himself hides within himself the money of his Lord, and that which is thought, and that which he thought he had shall be taken away from him. Blessed is the servant who esteems himself no better when he is praised and exalted by people than when he is considered worthless, simple, deplorable, for what a man is before God, that he is, and nothing more. And that reminds me, so pure, so balanced that none but self can comprehend, that when you're being praised or when you're being shamed, you are the same. Woe to the religious who have been placed in a high position over others and does not wish to come down of his own will. And blessed is the servant who does not place himself in a high position of his own will and always desires to be under the feet of others. Blessed is the religious who take no pleasure and joy except in the most holy weeks and deeds of the Lord, and those who lead people to the love of God in joy and gladness. Woe to the religious who delight in idle and frivolous words, and with those provoke people to laughter. Blessed is the servant who accepts correction, accusation, and blame from another as patiently as he would for himself. Blessed is the servant who is found to be a humble amongst his subjects as he would be amongst his masters. Blessed is the servant who would love his brother as much as when he is sick and cannot repay him, as when he is well and can repay him. Blessed is the servant who would love and respect his brother as much when he is far from him as he would have if he was with him. Where there is charity and wisdom, there is neither fear nor ignorance. Where there is patience and humility, there is neither anger nor disturbance. Where there is poverty and joy, there is neither covetousness or avarice. Where there is inner peace and meditation, there is neither anxiousness nor dispensation. Where there is fear of the Lord to guard the house, there the enemy cannot gain entry. There, where there is mercy and discernment, there is neither excess nor hardness of heart. So take these words of Saint Francis, you know, and a lot of things really changed through the ages. Like when they talk about poverty, when I was being trained as a priest, we were taught that poverty is like not thinking you have it all. So like if you have poverty of spirit, like, oh, you don't know everything and you're teachable. So there's a, when you think of poverty, not as being poor, but that you don't have it, that it's not that you're not the end all and be all. I think that like gives the concept of wanting to be in poverty a real positive connotation. I know a lot of people think, oh yeah, I don't want to do that because I don't want to be poor. You know, you can have everything, but it's not really yours, but God gives it all to you to use. And you can still have poverty, a poverty of spirit, a poverty of not being able to do it yourself. So they were the three readings. And as we reflect on the gifts that St. Francis gave us, I want you to look inside and see, like, maybe just one thing that you could change that would help you take on more and more of this kind of energy. When you read the stories of his men, you know, they were so human. Sometimes they didn't want to go out and beg. Sometimes they were tired of being cold and grumbled. But that didn't stop them from being a force of love for God and for working with the poor and for caring and for doing the inner transformation. You know, you can do all the outer stuff, but you're not doing the best you can if you don't do the inner stuff. The inner stuff is even more important than going out, because when you raise your vibration, you'll raise the vibration of the entire planet. So, that's my blessings from St. Francis today. So I'm going to turn this over to Amma Ruth. And I would love it if you could either play that music again or recite, because I know you know it, recite the St. Francis prayer before we go into communion.
Thank you, Bea.
Welcome.
Connected to Denzai Home 2. Deb's iPhone 2, disconnected, ready to pair. Deb's iPhone 2. Connected to Deb's iPhone 2.
Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, where there is darkness, where there is sadness, joy.
Mother, Father most glorious, and Christos most high, through the great masters of earth, Jesus and Mary, we beseech thee to absolve us of all past error and misgiving. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has taught us to pray. Our Father, Mother, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. O Lord of earth, thou granter of all prayers, it is my word that this bread shall be transmuted into the flesh of thy body and thy mind. Being transformed, I commend it in your memory for the forgiveness of sins. Glory unto the Creator for its power. Glory unto the mediators for their life. Glory unto the Holy Spirit for its nature. For thus is transformed the essence of earth and heaven. Amen. Into the blood of our most glorious Lord of earth, Jesus Christ. Amen. O God of creation, through thy holy word and through the power granted unto me over the life and the death of creation, do I commend myself unto the transformed wine and blood of our Lord Jesus for the raising of the consciousness. And may now the Holy Spirit descend through it and infuse it with life eternal. Amen.
Thank you.
All my friends gathered here partake of the body of Jesus, and know that by the fruits of your labors you are absolved of all past error and misgiving, and thus you are a partaker in the life through Christ Jesus. In Jesus and Mary's names this is done. In the name of the Creator, the Mediators, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Drink, my friends, of the blood of Jesus. It is infused with the essence of the great Christos above. Now go forth and let your light shine before all. In Jesus and Mary's names, this is done. In the name of the Creator, the Mediators, and the Holy Spirit. Mother, Father, Master Jesus, Blessed Mother Mary, all the angels and saints and helpers of our souls, all our ancestors that have gone before us, all our friends and family that have passed from this lifetime, we are so grateful that you are here with us today in our hearts, filling us with joy and peace. And knowing that we're all one, that we're all together, may we find solace in this. May we take the words of Saint Francis.
and be channels of your peace, be channels of your love. As we walk through this wonderful day, so blessed, so grateful that we know you. Thank you for helping us remember who we are. In your holy names, we pray. In the name of the Creator, the Mediators, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you all for coming. Have a beautiful, beautiful week. And may God's power flow through you. As you serve others. Peace.